I'm here on Estcourt Terrace redoing a video I did earlier, which I did on a not very good quality camera, but now I'm doing this with a very good quality HD camera. You can see that the street I'm walking up is in very good condition. There's a crack in a paving stone there, but these things can be repointed in. And the council, particularly Councillor Richard Lewis, are keen to replace the paving stones on this street, Estcourt Terrace, with what they call blacktop, this tarmac. There's no question that there are a number of damaged curbstones along this stretch. However, the curbstones are not the issue, because the council have agreed and have acknowledged that they do have sufficient stock of curbstones to replace the damaged ones, so we're not concerned about those. They're going to apparently do some work on this street in about a month, and they have stated that the paving stones in this street are in poor condition and are so bad that they all need to be replaced. Well, I think we can find out from this video that apart from a few cracks like this and the odd damaged one like that, on the whole, this street is in very good condition, particularly when one bears in mind this street was laid in about the era 1910 approximately. And we're not concerned about the curbstones, because the council have agreed they will be replacing those. Now, there are a few bad patches of the odd one that have been affected probably by roadworks. But then you get to other patches where you just go along and they're perfect for 10 yards or 20 yards or more at a time. And along here, well, frankly, there are hardly any bad ones at all. And the council's argument for taking up all these stone paving flags, which on this part of the street, lower part of Estcourt Terrace, okay, the top part is not in question, so we'll move over to the other side now. And this, the paving slabs on this part of the street, on both sides put together, if you look at this, you'll see, look, there's a whole row of almost perfect condition paving flags on the north side, or is it the east side, I should say. I don't think we've seen a bad one yet on this section that I'm filming here. So I just don't think I've seen a bad one. Oh look, there's one that's cracked, which can be, see, the ones that have only got one crack in them, they can be re-pointed in. I've seen council work do that on restored pavements, and it's not a problem. It's within their own engineering standards. Going along here, now that the students have gone and their rubbish is gone, there's one bad one there, and then another cracked one there, and then we're on to many, many near perfect ones. These ones which have just the occasional crack in them would not, under normal circumstances, be removed and replaced. So we're going down here. This is, there's one bad one. There's one bad one for about every 30 or 40 or more. I shall have to do an analysis of the numbers when I have finished this, but the council is planning to strip out all this, all these flagstones, all these good ones, which just go on for yard after yard, 10 yards after 10 yards, because of the fact that there are some bad curbstones. It is agreed, there are some bad curbstones. They have their own resources, because they stripped up over 300 good curbstones from Langdale Gardens and Langdale Terrace, back Langdale Terrace along here just a year ago. And, well, I don't think anybody will argue that the street here needs to be resurfaced, but they're probably going to strip the cobbles, and I wonder if that original iron grating will survive, which, as you can see, there we are, 120 years old or 100 years old or something, and that looks perfectly good to me, but we'll probably get a new one and that will disappear. We don't know where these things go to, because they don't seem to get recycled. So now, here we are, I'm back onto the lower part of Estcourt Terrace, and again, got some lovely rounded curbstones there. And here we go. Most of these flags are whole. There's one there, you see that has been pointed in previously. There's no reason why it can't be done again. And then we go down here, and there's barely one bad one. There's the odd bit filled in with tarmac, the odd little bit of lamination. There we go down here, and then we go down to the bottom again. See these stones, which are, in fact, the two lower ones are actually entire. That's just natural pointing, and that one there has been pointed in, and it's quite serviceable, completely safe. Get another 50 years out of that. And now here we have an example of the replacement drain covers, which the council insists on putting in, whereas on the other side we still have an original one, which is also much better situated in that rainwater can now go down, because it's sunk in, water goes down. And yet here, this, the kerb is only about an inch above the tarmac of the street, and so you see that the one on the other side, the old one, the original one, is much better set in the ground. And also this is what we got in place with there. I don't think they're as nice looking as the old ones. But that is probably the least of our worries about this street, because the Council Highways Department and its boss, Councillor Richard Lewis, are determined to remove this fine Edwardian street of paving. And cover it all up with what he calls blacktop. This. In fact, while I'm here, I will just pan back out here onto this here, which you might say, well, that's all right, it's nice and smooth. Well, in fact, if you look closely at it, it is not smooth, and so you have patches like that. Puddles accumulate along here, and it actually sags in the middle. It's hard to tell with this particular shot, but it is the case that for much of the distance along here on Kirkstall Lane, the pavement, the new tarmac pavement, actually sags. There is no proper camber to it, and it gets lots and lots of puddles along here. I'll just look further along here on the other side. And that has also, you might be able to see it on that one, that it does actually sag in the middle down where between here and where that bin is. So not only do these flagstones not need replacing, if they were to be replaced, then we would probably have a very much poorer quality surface, which would not be regular and which would sag and allow puddles in it. When the necessary work on resurfacing this street were to go ahead, but even then people might say, well, why not leave one of these streets with the original cobbles? And it's clearly, it's all, there's enough of them there, just had a layer of tarmac put on them, so you could do that, and it would be a splendid maintenance of our heritage from Edwardian times, which I think is probably when this street was built, and the frontage is. I'm just videoing and documenting this now so that we know and we can see the state of this road, and if the Council Highways Department tries to argue that the flagging was all broken and unsafe, then we have this video that demonstrates it was not. The road does need resurfacing. Quite a few of the kerbs need replacing, which they have in stock. And the flags do not need replacing. You can just relay a few of them that might be slightly irregular, repoint, and then we'll have it restored to original condition, and it would be able to last for many, many years ahead, rather than this ugly, unsightly, unsustainable, and also environmentally less desirable surface. Okay, well, I hope you found that interesting. Thank you for watching, and I hope you will think about the sort of situation we have with the unnecessary removal of this wonderful stone paving that we still have over 100 years old.